Okay, here we are with Eli Lake. You know Eli Lake. He's my favorite writer at the New York Sun, the world's next great newspaper. And why are we talking to Eli Lake? We're talking to Eli Lake because, in my opinion, he's an authority on the situation in Iran. You want to give us your take on it? Not editorially. This is just Eli and Pamela chilling conversation.
Yeah. Okay. Iran.
Yeah.
What's the situation at this point?
Yeah.
Well, the story that I had for the weekend edition, and I think that this is the most important thing that people should be looking at, is that there is beginning to see evidence that Iran has had a deliberate strategy to influence and some would say infiltrate the largely Shia militias, but now what is the Iraqi government. And that situation right now means that as we take on Iranian Quds Force members in Iraq, as the president said on Friday, we're going to see more and more the mettle of the government, and it's going to be very difficult rooting out the people who are basically agents for the Iranians inside. That's a major issue. The other thing is this, is that everywhere you go, the UN reports, there's recently UN reports that the Shiite Iranian Quds Force is selling arms to the Sunni Islamic Courts Union in Mogadishu, who are causing all these problems and imposing Sharia law there. We see the Iranian hand in Lebanon, you see the Iranian hand, according to the Israelis in Israel, you see the Iranian hand clearly in its alliance with the Syrians, and you see the Iranian, at least according to my reporting, the people are saying that they're seeing now evidence the Iranians also will work with Sunni jihadists who are trying to kill Shia, so they're in many ways trying to play both sides of the civil war. That's the situation that the Americans have to deal with, and guess what, they want a nuclear weapon. The specifics on whether these centrifuges and kicking out inspectors and so forth are really, you have to see in the larger part of the program. In 2003, after the Iraq War, Iran admitted to having a clandestine program that it didn't admit to the IAEA. The terms of having that program meant that they had to allow for spot inspections. If you go back and read the IAEA reports, they never really allowed spot inspections. There were always obstacles. Earlier this year, as we know, Mohammed al-Baradei effectively fired the inspector who was on site in Iran after the Iranians said that. And now, the one that they wanted, they don't even like, so they're not allowing that. These are, in diplomatic jargon, this is called confidence-building measures. The Iranians are not living up to those confidence-building measures, so it doesn't, you don't need me, I'm not in Iran. You don't need, Undersecretary Negroponte or some American official or a French official to tell you they think this intelligence or they're this many years away. We've established a process. Iranians have reneged on this process. There are consequences through the UN. But there may need to be more consequences.
But, you know, I don't know if you saw Ambassador Bolton's recent remarks about those consequences, quote-unquote consequences from the UN. What he called a very weak resolution, faulty, if I'm not mistaken. And I'm going to quote with Ambassador Bolton. Then again, I'm going to quote with Ambassador Bolton on everything. That's what the lefties think. But I am, actually. Yeah. And my point to you is that, really, is the UN the answer at this point? What should America, I mean, if you were in the big house.
Yeah, if I was in the big house.
If you were in the big house, what action would you take? What tact would you take?
I would not. I would at this point not rely on the United Nations to take serious actions against countries because it builds in a veto for the Russians, which we know are a very corrupted. We can't call them a democracy. I guess what do we call them? A kind of a corporate dictatorship, I suppose.
Right.
A KGB state. We know that the Chinese and the Russians so far have said that the threat of countries that sponsor terrorism and also pursue weapons of mass destruction is not really a threat to them. And they probably believe in side deals that they're cutting, but the Russians are going to find out in Chechnya that the jihad is interested in them as well. So I don't think that the UN is really an effective tool. But that said, I think it's very interesting that the Treasury Department has for the last 2 years really directly gone after major Iranian banks and funds for these groups. You might see some, you know, that certainly has an effect. And also what Bolton started, which was an initiative that is voluntary groups. I forget what is that called? It's the coalition. The initiative to interdict ships.
Yeah, to interdict.
Which I don't know. I'm sorry. The interdiction effort. I'm sorry. That's that the name is not the Proliferation Security Initiative. There.
Hey.
Okay. So these sorts of efforts may work, and you're starting to hear more and more from some segments. I talked to you in the counterterrorism community. The phrasing goes like this: for every Iranian IED that goes off in Iraq, once you go off in Iran. So you may see groups, America begin clandestinely to work with groups that we wouldn't have worked with before, that one, some might say, for because they're terrorists, one of them might be the MEK. I'm not necessarily in favor of that. I want to make it very clear.
Okay.
But there are
not
people
talking. Not in favor of that.
Not in favor of the MEK, but there are groups like that. Also, some of the Kurdish organizations like the PKK. I hope this isn't too technical, Pamela.
It doesn't. My people love technical.
Okay, that's what I think you're going to see.
Okay.
It's the Reagan Doctrine. What you saw in the U.S. did in Nicaragua and Angola in the 1980s, you're going to see America the rest of this decade and beyond probably do against Iran and other states that are working on the other side in this war.
Eli, do you know that you rock my world?
No.
Now listen, now you just told us, oh stop, I'm just okay. So that I can say, okay, yep, come Atlas, get you the real story, Atlas, get you the story that nobody else gives you, it's the truth, unfettered, unaccessed, here, now, okay? Eli Lake, you rock, baby, thank you.
Thank you, that's cool,
yeah,
thank you so much,
cool.
That's so cool.
Pamela,
yeah.
I want to say hello.